For example, if a policeman is out on the street, those are strictly for him to call the station house.
That's their sole purpose.
They're not going to hurt you. Lieutenant, this is our witness, Cynthia Trumbull. She's going to view the lineup.
It's good of you to come in, Miss Trumbull.
Well, I could be murdered at any time, so I hope you appreciate it.
Yeah, we certainly do. You're very important to us. They ready to go?
Yeah, we're all set.
Okay, let's have a look at the lineup, Miss Trumbull.
No.
No.
Not unless you meet my conditions.
I didn't hear about any condition.
I think Cynthia's going to lay that all out for you now.
I want your surveillance cameras shut down. I want all recording devices turned off. And I don't want anybody zeroing in on me with eavesdropping equipment.
All right. I'll meet your conditions. That's a commitment. Shall we go?
Oh. There you go.
Okay. Thank you.
You're going to be looking through one-way glass, Cynthia. You'll see them, they won't see you. If you recognize anybody, you tell us what number and where you recognize them from. Okay. I'm going to knock here.
You recognize anybody?
That's him, number three.
Where do you recognize him from?
Well, now I'm going to have to move to another town, but they'll find me wherever I go.
Cynthia, where do you recognize number three from?
These people have agents working for them. I'm not safe, and you know it. I mean, all they have to do is increase the electric current in my apartment. I mean, nobody would ever detect it, and I'd be dead.
You won't have to move. We'll put a fail-safe in with the electrical company.
Come on. Let me get this guy locked up. And off the street.
I recognize number three from the stairway in my building. He dragged the other one up to the roof.
Hold number three.
They just took a snapshot of the lineup. When that's developed, they'll bring in the squads and give you a sign.
Is that going to be a long delay?
Not if you can believe Polaroid.
I don't believe any large company, and I'm quite certain he's selling it with the glass.
That really is impossible. Detective Simone Sipowitz will pick you up around 8. We'll need you at the grand jury tomorrow morning.
I'll be ready if they haven't got to me yet.
Arthur, this is Mr. Owen Devlin, counsel for Francis Donahue.
I want to show you these fish here.
Naomi, actually, I'd prefer if you call me Lieutenant.
I wanted to call you Lieutenant. I somehow got it in my mind that you preferred Arthur.
Is my client being held?
He's been arrested for murder.
On what basis is he charged?
Who called you?
One of Mr. Donahue's associates.
Donahue volunteered to stand in the lineup. A witness picked him out.
Mr. Donahue's not the volunteering type. I'd like to talk to him.
Sit down and wait. You'll see your client as soon as we get him in the cell.
I messed up.
They seem to be staring at me.
Anyways, maybe we can take you home now.
No, I'm afraid to move.
What's the matter?
That man we walked past is very sinister. He knew about events before they'd occurred.
Well, we can take you another way out.
No, once telepathy's involved, that doesn't matter.
Cynthia.
I feel him enveloping my cranium.
What was Paco's weasel mean, Cynthia? You know? Here we go around the mulberry bush. The monkey chased the weasel.
It's the cobbler's bench.
No.
See, I said it was the cobbler's bench, too.
Yeah. All around the cobbler's bench, the monkey chased the weasel. The monkey thought 'twas all in fun. Pop goes the weasel.
You know what that means?
A penny for a spool, a thread, a penny for a needle. That's the way the money goes. Pop goes the weasel.
See, now, I was never aware of that verse.
The weasel's chased and chased and chased. First by other animals, then his financial problems. Till finally, he can't take it anymore.
So what does he do?
He pops.
Uh-huh.